Okay, well, let's take this to the last segment. It's right or wrong. There's only two ways to answer this question. You can answer with a right or you can answer with a wrong. So I'm going to go to Melissa first, who will explain what we're talking about. You're almost going to answer the question before I can ask.
She's neural I'm so ready.
I'm not going to let you see the question.
Okay.
Do you know the question?
No.
Okay. Right or wrong, you'll want a foldable smartphone. Right or wrong?
I'm going to say wrong. I have seen foldable smartphones. I've seen prototypes from Lenovo, and we're actually working off of an article that came out within the last week with rumors that Samsung is also going to be coming out with a foldable phone as soon as next year.
Is it a flip phone with a hinge? Like what was the Lenovo one like?
The Lenovo one was it was like a book. It was like the two covers of a book. And so you could fold it in the middle. So it could be sort of, you know, the regular sort of vertically oriented smartphone. You unfold it and it becomes a tablet. And then they also had another smartphone that went around your wrist, kind of like a bracelet.
Oh, God.
Yeah, and same thing. It was, so you could kind of wear it. It was kind of
That's
like a
practical.
Smartwatch. Yeah. So they had two foldable prototypes. The Samsung prototypes are more like a foldable, just a sort of a book cover thing. So I have seen them, and you know they were working. The Lenovo prototypes were working, but they also had the armature out that you could see, and it's incredibly complicated. It's like articulated like the Surface Book, right? And you're thinking about, I'm going to put this on my wrist, this articulated caterpillar shaped smartwatch, and
drop it a few times.
So the foldable one, what was the when it was completely unfolded, what was the size of the display? Did it connect? So it was a seamless display when it was all.
Yeah, it was seamless. It was supposed to be, I mean, whatever, 6 or 7 or 8 inches. I mean, it wasn't going to be that big because it sort of folded into a phablet.
So it was a huge device.
It was a large phone, and then it folded into a small tablet, or folded out to be a small tablet.
Was there a bezel?
Yes, there was a bezel on the Lenovo.
So what's the Samsung story say? Like, what is it going to be like what you saw in the Lenovo demo?
Yeah, so this was actually based on a story from a South Korean publication called the Electronic Times, and they reported that Samsung was going to come out with these foldable phones next year. And they had pictures from a teaser video that Samsung had put out a while ago showing a woman folding a phone. So the reason I say no is because I think the circuitry for this to try and get that display to be foldable all the time and reliable and not start screwing up with your display is going to be pretty delicate. And so I kind of wouldn't want to deal with that. And I don't even want to think about what would happen when you drop that phone.
Okay. So let me ask Gordon. Gordon, right or wrong, you're going to want a foldable phone.
The correct answer is yes, you will want a foldable phone, and I'm looking for an image of it right now, but I can't because it's Surface RT. Oh, I don't even know if it even works.
He's typing.
Oh my God.
He typed Westworld.
Yes, Westworld computer, because who doesn't, who doesn't want a Westworld computer where they fold? Remember, if anybody watches Westworld, they take this thing out and they unfold it. And it's
that's
like,
not
oh,
a
that's,
spoiler. Yeah.
But I mean, that's like, wow, that's really nice. It's like an unfolding tablet, but there's no seam and a big, who wouldn't want that? If you could actually give me the West Wing or Westworld computer.
Yeah, West Wing.
About to see a foldable display, right, John? I mean, the idea that you can have a bigger display that you know, that isn't this huge thing you haul around with you is appealing.
Oh yeah. I'll answer the question, right or wrong. Yes, I want a foldable phone. I mean, one of the reasons, at least according to our article, that Samsung is doing this is they want to explore new formats. Like they need to shake up the space. And I mean, what we're finding, I mean, if the iPhone proves anything, it's like, yeah, everything's so incremental. Android phones are incremental, although I love the Pixel. So this takes us back to the age of flip phones. It's a novel form factor. I'm trying to figure out why I need it. I mean, I'm hoping, let's say it's this size, it gets folded up.
Yeah.
As long as it's not like super bulgy, it would be maybe nice to have a smaller phone that could be folded up so I could put it in a jacket pocket. So there's definitely some motivations of why I'd want it. I definitely want to see it as a tech journalist. So that's interesting.
Would you want the phone to like, so like I think you're always going to want to use it in your Dove bar or whatever shape. But like, so then you would unfold it and you'd get two screens, or then you could maybe fold it all the way back and have a screen on both sides.
Oh, definitely not both sides. I want to take this phone and fold it in half this way, just to make it smaller.
Oh, yeah. No, they're like talking about making it bigger.
Oh, like take this and double it.
Yes.
Ah.
But if you, I mean, if you think about it, if you have two
why not
screens,
go my way?
You do two screens and then, so you unfold it.
So it becomes a bigger,
it's like a Game Boy, Game Boy Advance. Remember, they have those double screens. And then, but when you're in a normal phone mode, you fold it all the way back and it's the size of a regular phone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Correct.
Well, that, I mean, what you're describing, or what, I guess what Samsung described, sort of could kill the tablet, because all of a sudden you do have a lot more display.
Mm-hmm.
So that's interesting.
Hmm.
But why not go for like a smart flip phone? Why not?
Nokia just introduced a flip phone, I think, right?
Yeah.
Or something.
Flip phones are supposed to be hot and trendy. Anyway, do we have any live comments on this topic before we get out?
No, not specifically. A lot of people saying that they're pretty interested in seeing what it is. Yeah. But yeah, they're trying to figure out what the benefit is, really. Yeah. CJ, especially on YouTube.
Do you guys anticipate you'll see this at CES?
No.
No,
but just look up Westworld computer and it's like, ooh, I would like one of those. That's
Tablet. To me, I saw it as a tablet.
What, the Westworld one?
Because I don't think they use it as a phone.
Yeah,
there was
a
phone though, too.
Well, no, because it was just when it was, you basically used it like a phone, you know, in a vertical box, and then they
unfolded
it.
That same device was the phone that was used too.
Yeah, because they would go out and they'd walk around and they'd be calling on them.
Yeah.
It's just one device.
Okay.
It's not like we, you know, with five devices kind of thing.
Right. Okay. It was one device.
But you know what I love in Westworld is when they go back, they go down into the basement where all the old crap is.
Yeah.
And they go, and they go like, oh, it's down there in storage. And then they have like an LCD. It was like a Dell monitor or something like that. And he fires up like, it's like a hard drive in it.
And the guy who Ford talked to, who moved like this. One of the really rudimentary early robots.
Yes.
Yeah, I like the mythology they created.
Both the old computers are kind of cool.
I don't remember the old computers.
Yeah. There was like a Dell 24-inch monitor. It's like, oh, man.
No.
Yeah.
I'm okay. I'll have to go look. Yeah, it's supposed to be like, I think the time it takes place is like 50. It's not even that far in the future.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's why they're sort of calling back to like, it's sort of based, you know, now and in the future. We don't want to give you all the spoilers, but...
Yeah, I don't think we've touched a single spoiler yet.
Except that Star Wars may suck.
Are we getting attacked for spoilers on the live feeds?
No. Yeah. Just from me. I haven't seen a single thing on it. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Uh-uh. Oh. I'm waiting for the season to be done.
You got to get yourself a HBO Go login from someone.
I know I do.
Yeah.
Hint, hint.
Okay. Well, hey, that was a good show. We've had a good year on the PC World show. Reminder, this...
Whoops.
What?
Sorry about
Adam's
that.
Ooh, so
that's
upset.
The hook. We're getting the hook.
Here's your hat.
Sorry about that.
Yeah. We had a great year. Thanks for joining us live. And I'm not going to CES, but these two are. So you'll see them on some live broadcasts from CES. But once again, thanks for joining us for episode 36 of the PC World Show. Thank you, Gordon.
See ya.
And thank you, Melissa.
Happy holidays.
And bye, everyone.